Yes, yes, yes. We have new witnesses, new evidence, as the Queen's favorite son, Prince Andrew, is essentially canceled. Right now, there's a firestorm spreading of information that is absolutely explosive and is shocking people all around this world that we will be covering in this video. Also, specifically getting into the cover-up that is happening right now. And of course, the bigger questions that still loom in this entire Epstein case that stinks to high heaven of corruption, especially federal government institutions. That I still don't understand why some people put their trust in, but there should be absolutely no trust in these institutions after just looking at some of the evidence presented in this entire Epstein scandal. Now, we're going to do this plus a lot more in this free video for you, mainly because we're supported by you. And if it wasn't for your physical mail, cryptocurrencies, you guys getting involved with our affiliate codes, or just even a 1 month donation, we wouldn't be here. And that's why I want to thank everyone who gets involved, clicks that button on wearechange.org/donate, and decides to fight along this very independent news organization that has been warning about Epstein for years. And I have to say, it is absolutely incredible, almost indescribable, to see what is unfolding right now with headlines finally, and I mean finally, shedding light on some of the most sinister, secretive, occult, shadowy, disgusting areas of our society that finally the general public gets to see. And the powerful people committing these acts are finally facing true justice in the court of public opinion. Now, the actual judicial court, the quote, justice system, and what's happening in that arena, we'll get into in this video as well. But specifically in the court of public opinion, I mean, it's astonishing seeing even CNN with headlines like this that talk about a nightmare PR scenario for Prince Andrew, which they call a national joke. Insider saying that this has set his reputation on fire. And yeah. Rightfully so, which needs to be pointed out here from all the information that we're getting. We're also getting new information from new accusers coming forward from people like this woman who describes at the age of 15 doing the most horrible things that we will not mention in this video because of how disturbing they actually are. As of course, now about a dozen women are suing Jeffrey Epstein's estate for the abuse that they allege happened. And of course, many of them are implicating Prince Andrew, including this new Jane Doe anonymous victim that is saying that Prince Andrew must come forward with information about exactly what happened with him and Jeffrey Epstein. And again, when you actually look at the grooming, trafficking of children that took place here, by the way, not just a dozen children, but there's even testimony of one mogul procuring around 1,000 children to Jeffrey Epstein. So their number is close to thousands of children that were abused here. When you look at what was happening to them and how the authorities, the police, the FBI, the people who are supposed to be investigating this, the people who are supposed to be actually doing something about this, just allowed it and aided and abetted this behavior, it is shocking, to say the least, and it should rattle the core of anyone who has any significant trust to any government, because it showed how the government was in on this child trafficking ring, with even a new accuser coming forward saying that she once took Bill Clinton's seat. By the way, the same Bill Clinton that ditched his Secret Service over a dozen times and has been listed in the flight logs for Jeffrey Epstein's airplane, which of course Clinton remains completely, quote, innocent about, saying that he had no idea what was going on, which is actually absolutely just incredulous and impossible when you look at the evidence and the witness testimony here. It is impossible. It is impossible for Bill Clinton not to know what was happening on here. But again, describing things like bedroom floors made of mattress phones and just evil behavior, even encouraging victims to cry after being physically forced to have relations with these monsters. There's even unknown numbers of missing children related to these cases. And again, all of this with protection from the federal authorities. And this is why it's so critically important to be skeptical to what is happening next in this important case. Because if we look at the scenario, if we look at the situation, the federal authorities were in on this for over a decade. Now that we're supposed to trust the same people who didn't stop it, who aided and abetted it to supposedly investigate, including the attorney general right now assigned by Trump to this case that has connections to Epstein? Are you kidding me? And again, as we covered this news yesterday, there are criminal charges expected, but they're expected against the prison guards, essentially the patsies, essentially the nobodies that are being just thrown to the wolves here when in all actuality, their crime is absolutely minimal compared to the large enterprises of abuse that were facilitated here. And again, two prison guards, that's all we're going to get here. When Ghislain Maxwell, who by the way here is seen with CNN boss's Jeff Zucker's wife, she who has been accused by many of the witnesses, many of the women coming forward who say that they were abused by her when they were children as well, while she is still somewhere unknown. And of course, Prince Andrew hasn't even been questioned yet about his obvious involvement and participation in this extortion abuse ring that was happening. And again, we have to understand here, there's a lot more happening than of course we're being told. There's a reason Epstein supposedly, quote, committed suicide and died with so many secrets, because those secrets were so devastating for the public to find out that they had to stage this public execution, or hell, who even knows? Maybe just escape. We don't know exactly what happened, but the true people in power who are more powerful than we could even imagine, more powerful than the labeled billionaire Epstein, those people would rather make this huge mess than face the consequences of the truth coming out about how crazy this entire case is. And again, one thing we have to look at is, of course, clear intelligence agency ties that, of course, Ghislain Maxwell and her father, media mogul Mr. Maxwell, had, and the connections Jeffrey Epstein had, and how all the evidence now points to a large extortion racket that was being run with the child trafficking organizations being used as evidence to collect dirt on very powerful people in order to manipulate them. As we're also getting new information that there was pinhole cameras and monitors watching private moments of very powerful individuals. Of course, the large amount of underage children around that were being trafficked. Now, again, the bigger question here is where's Ghislain? Where's Miss Maxwell? Why isn't the media up in arms? Why aren't the federal authorities that we know of out there looking for her or seeking her to even just question her? Because again, we already have a lot of witnesses coming forward directly pointing her as even potentially being the bigger person above Epstein. Why isn't she even being questioned? Where is she? Why is she missing? Why isn't anyone else in the mainstream media raising these important questions about Ghislain Maxwell? And the only information we're gathering is literally on Reddit subreddits with investigative journalists and volunteers putting information together surrounding this case. And again, it's mind-blowing. Miss Maxwell here, she was also a helicopter operator. She also was licensed to operate a submarine. I mean, can you imagine what they were using a freaking submarine for? When, of course, she was using her helicopter license to fly into the private island and on the New Mexico resort without being spotted by other authorities. But a submarine license? I mean, what were these individuals up to, and where is she? Last we seen her, she was reading and staged a fake photo op that was, again, sold to us as someone randomly walking by and taking a photo of her. But then we found out that there was actually marketing placed in that photo for, of course, a Hollywood movie. But again, the last we saw her, she was reading a book about CIA assassinations in California, and now we know nothing else. Now, this should make anyone, especially a journalist or someone portraying themselves as a journalist, curious to what is happening here and investigate this. But I'm not seeing anyone do this at all. And we're still seeing just gratification of the royal family, just brown-nosing, ass-kissing of these inbred cretins that believe that they're better because of their bloodline, with just stupid articles about these reptilian looking like bug-eyed individuals, quote, sharing a joke. They're wearing a dazzling dress. Who gives a damn? I know, I as hell don't. They're celebrating like everything's fine. And again, everyone here knows nothing is fine. The royal family is directly implicated here, and everyone knows it. And guess what? This is not the first time that they were implicated. And then out of touch media personalities that worship these ghouls are trying to defend these monsters with their absolute brain retardation, with this Skeletor looking like creature even coming out on British television saying that soliciting physical relations with children is, quote, not pedophilia. What the frick is wrong with these demented, sick, twisted individuals who just believe that they're above the law? They should absolutely be slapped up with the reality of discontent that the majority of people are having against them. And again, the mainstream media establishment is fighting tooth and nail. They're crawling and trying to grab on to anything they can to save face here. And when they're doing it, they're looking absolutely out of touch and ridiculous. Again, the queen's being described as putting on a brave face. Are you kidding me? She's the one that gave the go-ahead to this interview. And now people are more worried about this wrinkled prune than they are over the obvious child victims here, which should be the priority, not the old hag queen. The Duchess of York, the wench that is somehow bound and married to this monster, Prince Andrew, is coming out and saying Andrew should have never been put in that position, that he's not very quick on his feet, and that his press secretary is responsible here. No, you crooked little disgusting wench. The press secretary is not responsible here. We finally got a look. We finally had a light shed on the darkness that is entrapped and involved with your sick little twisted bloodline. We finally got a glimpse into the truth of what's actually happening here. And you're trying to shift blame here. Meanwhile, it was this same Duchess of York hag lady that, again, Jeffrey Epstein, by the way, paid off her entire debt. What did she do? What did she do? She needs to go to jail too. Let's question her. Let's sit down with her. Let the BBC or some other journalist interview her. What did she do to Jeffrey Epstein? What did she procure for Jeffrey Epstein that Jeffrey Epstein paid off this, quote, Duchess of York's debt? And again, they're all interconnected in so many sinister ways. And again, finally, after years of speaking about this, of talking about this, of raising this issue, now, finally, there's some actual consequences as we're seeing, not only a public outcry, which looks like the only court that actually will have some kind of effect here, but many learning institutions and business institutions are pulling their plug and relationship with Prince Andrew, firing him as chancellor. They're calling for him to step down of any educational institution. And yeah, of course, he should immediately. And again, this is going far to even conversations being started about Prince Andrew being canceled and potentially being stripped away of his royal duties, which is an actual possibility here, which should happen. But again, this will not happen as the Queen is still alive, but would potentially happen when Prince Charles steps in. But again, even media personalities like Piers Morgan, who, by the way, is also pictured with Ghislaine Maxwell, but he even himself is saying he doesn't believe a word that Prince Pinocchio, as he's describing him, said, and he's recommending that he should turn himself in to the FBI or his public life is finished. Yeah, there's other chancellors talking about how Prince Andrew was a complete disgrace and how he needs to fly to the United States immediately to give evidence that he has of anything involving Jeffrey Epstein and abuse of children, since again, he knows a lot more than he is saying. He was also just named in more explosive evidence against him. And as some witnesses says, he was even being used as bait for other underage women to lure them into the trafficking ring that they were running. And again, everything about Prince Andrew's official story, as we covered in yesterday's video, which is available right here and will be linked in the description below so you could watch, almost everything he was spouting off during his, quote, car crash interview was just an absolute lie. And of course, more evidence, more information is coming out confirming that. Essentially creating a situation that people are comparing this interview to the, quote, second worst car crash that the royal family has organized. And again, the buck doesn't stop here with just Jeffrey Epstein. This is not the first time that the family has had a major pedophile scandal, with reports of how Prince Charles was calling Jimmy Savile a horrible pedophile necrophiliac, his best friend. So yeah, as this case unfolds, I cannot remind you guys enough. Your voice, you getting the information out there, you showing the world how you are angry about this actually matters and has an effect. We're seeing some results, but we still have a long way to go to actually get full justice here on this mystery that has been essentially covered up. And the only way to uncover it is to keep pushing for the truth in this case. What's happening right now is absolutely incredible. I am so happy to be alive in this moment when finally, some of this information is coming to light. And that's because of a lot of brave individuals. That's because of independent media. That's because of lawyers and witnesses that are not afraid to come out. And again, they're not afraid to come out because they know that they have the public support. Let them know this. Share this video with your friends and family members, because of course YouTube definitely won't. They attack us and censor us while promoting ABC that has been, of course, covering up for Epstein for over 3 years now. So share this video with your friends and family members right now, because if you don't, Google won't, and no one else will see it. And because you guys still do that, because we still have a voice, because we still are able to run independently, giving you this video for free, giving you all of the research and homework and interviews and even storming Jeffrey Epstein's island, all of this wouldn't be possible without you. And this is why I try to end every single video by saying, I love you guys. Stay tuned for more here on WeAreChange.org.